Then Ramon Simone said, you know, you'd be great as a real estate broker. He said, you got such a good personality. I'm going to give you $1,000. Let's start a real estate business. I wish I could take credit for the idea. Said, oh, that was my dream. It wasn't. My attitude on that one was, hey, I've had 22 jobs so far. Why not try another one? That was it. And so we started the Corcoran Simone Company. I had moved in with Ramon Simone. After I moved in with him, he told me he had 3 daughters. They moved in with us. No problem. I'm good with kids, right? We had 14 lovely rental agents within 7 years. I felt on top of the world. And then Ramon mentioned one night, he said, you know, we have something serious to discuss. And he said, I'm going to marry your secretary. Tina, that bitch? I didn't really say that, but in my head I said it. You know what I mean? I thought I was in somebody else's bad dream, like slow motion when you're in a car crash from what I hear. I'm like, what? Her? Tina? No. He goes, yeah, don't get upset. We're madly in love. We're going to get married. He said, it'll really take your time moving out. I was out of there in about a minute with my toothbrush. Moved on to my best friend. I just went right to her house and she let me in and I started living off her couch. Now, what happened after that, I'm ashamed of, because I was a pretty happy-go-lucky person, thinking relatively secure. But somehow when that happened, I felt like my whole insides were pulled out. After all, Ray had found me in Edgewater. After all, he believed in me. He was my mentor. He was my boyfriend. He gave me a family. I was very, very, very fond of his three daughters. We worked together. I mean, it was my whole world, really, if you think about it. It took me about a year going in and seeing Ray and Tina. I couldn't fire her, he said, because he was a 51% shareholder, which was true. But when I finally, one day, somehow got brittle. I don't know what clicked. I can't even tell you what it was. But on a Friday morning, I said, you know, Ramon, this is what we're going to do. We're going to divide this business. We're ending it today. He couldn't believe it. And I went to my existing landlord, and I got the exact same office, 2 floors higher than Ray. And I got it for 20% cheaper. And Monday morning came, we had desks, chairs, and a phone. And what do you need in a real estate business? Just people. And they moved into that ass, and they sat down, and we were in business. Bang. And that was the beginning of the Corcoran Group. When I left the door that day, when we ended that business, because Ray, rightfully, I think, now in hindsight, was angry. It was like he getting hit broadside, okay? But Ray gave me the gift of a lifetime. He said to me, you know, Barbara, you will never succeed without me. And you know what? If he had said, you know, Barbara, you're amazing. I'm sure you'll do fine. I don't believe I would have stayed in business in the tough times. It was my sheer ego of that insult that burned so deep in my soul that when all the chips were down, I thought I had tried everything in the world, everything I could possibly think to stay in business. Real estate goes up and down and up and down. I would think of those words and son of a gun, I would think, bing, one new thing. And that one new thing was always the thing that got me through. So he really gave me a gift, thank you. And of course, he was wrong, haha, because I sold my business maybe 22 years later for $66 million. Now for the next part. Okay, all right.